Thanks for watching another vlog about Yamaha's Rivage digital mixing systems. If you've never mixed on one before, you're probably itching for the first chance. So let me show you how to prepare and where to start. I expect many sound engineers will begin with the Rivage PM editor software. Download it for free from yamahaproaudio.com. Then, when you open the editor, choose between the flagship PM10 and the lower channel count PM7. But don't worry about selecting the wrong one. The files you create are interchangeable. Anyway, you are going to see the same graphical user interface as on the console screens, but just perhaps without the touch facility. Never mind, there are some handy keyboard shortcuts. Firstly, the Escape key will toggle between the 12-channel overview and the selected channel, and F2 will do the same. Then keys F3 to F6 will access the other important menus shown below the meter bridge. So we've got Monitor, Rack, Setup, and Patch. Now, when the Rivage RPIO units are used with the twin lane fiber optic ring, you have to bear in mind that they are modular units, so every system could be different. If you don't know the exact configuration in advance, it's best to skip the patch programming. So let's go straight to the channel name page. As you type the selected channel name, press Tab to move to the next one. So Snare, Tab, Hat, Tab, Tom 1, Tab, and so on. Or you can Shift and Tab to go back through the channels. When you're done with the names, press Escape and look at the selected channel. You can use a meter bridge to navigate around all the channels. So you can set EQs, dynamics, high pass filters, delays, inserts, DCA assignments, and so on. And if you want to make a stereo pair, then touch the little heart icon at the bottom left of the selected channel. If you want to copy settings to other channels, you can use the channel job menu. When you're done, go to the scene memory page and store the scene. And then save the file to a USB key. You go to the setup menu and save and load. Now, when it's time to set up the hardware, note that any interface can go in any slot of the RPIO units. You could have inputs first or outputs first. So you can follow your own logical order. Its configuration will be automatically discovered by the console. To connect RPIO units to the DSP engine, create a fiber optic ring connecting from out to in each time. Then you need two Cat5e or Cat6 cables between console and DSP engine, also connected out to in. Make these connections before powering on. I suggest you then power on the RPIO units first and check their ID numbers. They should be M1, M2, M3 in logical order. Set them from the front menu. Then power on the DSP engine and check its ID. If you are using only one, make sure it has ID 1. Finally, power on the console. It will automatically detect the devices and show the device sync screen. You can choose whether to transfer the parameter settings from the IO units and the DSP to the console, or overwrite the DSP and IO settings with those that are stored in the console. If you haven't created any scenes yet, it doesn't matter which way to go. Now you can load your data from the USB key and recall a scene. Open the setup menu and save load. Choose your file and load. Now in the scene menu, we can recall your scene. Remember, we need to make a patch before we can hear audio. But even before that, we need to make a bit of system configuration. Open the setup menu and go to the system config. In a Rivage system, we can have up to 8 RPIO units on one twin lane ring. That could mean over 750 mic preamps. But our twin lane ring can carry only 400 channels. And out of that 400, 256 can be delivered to the DSP engine. So we have to select which inputs are going to be put onto the network and which outputs are going to be taken from the DSP back to the RPIO units. We start by opening up the first RPIO. For each input card that you're going to use, touch the number at the bottom and all its inputs will be selected. For slots like HY2 that has over 100 channels, you can select in blocks of 16. Press apply to activate all those channels. You can see the total number of channels in the network at the bottom right. Close that window and do the same for any other RPIO units. Don't assign the DA converter cards. That will waste twin lane channels. They are going to take audio from the network, not put audio in. Next, we open the DSP and we select which of the mixer's output channels need to return back through the twin lane network to the RPIO units. You don't need to select them if they're only going to be output locally. So we open the mix window and select which mix buses we will send back to stage. We could say all on. And then the same for matrix and stereo masters. It's unlikely to need many direct outputs and inserts on stage, but it is possible. Then apply and be sure that you haven't reached the limit of 400. Now we are ready to patch. In the patch menu and input page, you will see all the input cards that we assigned to twin lane and all the input channels listed vertically. To make a quick patch, select the starting point and then press the diagonal shortcut and use touch and turn to complete the line. Then use the output patch to link mixer channels to output connections. Now we should be able to raise the gains and the faders to hear audio. And it's time to use your skill and creativity with the sound. You can select your favorite silk texture, your preferred EQ type, and all the virtual circuitry modeling plugins you need to provide a sublime sound, ready to satisfy the most discerning concert goers and on-stage performers. But before we finish, please remember to check your word clock setup. Setup menu and word clock. Make sure you're running at the expected sample rate. 96K is the default. And then check your delay compensation in case you need all your outputs to be phase coherent. Wow, no other mixing system of this scale is so convenient and intuitive. Look out for training seminars and demos, hopefully coming to a place near you soon.